Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a Q&A, question and answer. I asked you guys on Twitter, or bitch, not Twitter, Instagram, bloop. I went on Instagram and I asked you guys to leave me some questions and you guys left me a couple, you know, a cute 5,000. Obviously, I can't answer all of those right now, but I'm going to try to answer as many as possible without, we're not gonna have a repeat of 2016 with my ringer going off in almost every single video. But we're not gonna do the whole 20-30 minute video today because honestly, you guys, that's what I've been doing. Since I came back on YouTube, my videos have been way too damn long. So we're not doing that today. So I'm gonna start with honestly the most requested question, which is, what did you use to grow your hair? Or are you gonna dye your hair again? Or is that your natural hair? So let me just talk about my hair. So if you are new to my channel, or maybe you haven't been here when, or maybe you weren't here when I buzzed my hair off, you know, I was giving very Halsey vibes at the moment, but I went ahead and shaved my hair because my hair was very damaged. If you watched me way back and went, if you watched me way back when, I was dyeing my hair pink, green the next week, blue, purple, all these different colors, experimenting with glue on tracks, like, no. So it has been like a year and 2 months since I basically started all over. And I got my hair cut last week, so this isn't how long as it has grown. It actually grew maybe like half an inch or an inch longer than this, but I just got it kind of like trimmed up so my hair can like grow like more evenly. And it's not all the same length yet. They tried to give me some sort of layers, don't know. I really don't know what happened back there, but I'm kind of just trying to grow it out at this point. But I didn't use anything special in my hair to grow it out. I didn't damage it. It was basically in braids the entire year. I was wearing wigs a lot. I got sew-ins at some point. I was basically like not touching my actual hair, so maybe that's why it grew so quick. Will I be dyeing my hair? Big N-O. No, I did not take a year and a half of my life to grow this dead skin cells out just to ruin it again. Oh, this is cute. Somebody asked, how do you stay healthy with a clear face and a healthy body? You think I'm healthy? Thank you. Girl. Girl. Vanessa Gabriela Martinez does not go in the same sentence as healthy. But I can tell you that what helps my skin is what you will find out in my next video coming on later this week. I'm actually gonna show you guys what I did to my skin. Let's just say I burnt all my skin off again and it basically got rid of the acne. You know, your girl right now is dealing with a cute little pimple right now, a little Mount Olympus on my forehead. But other than that, my skin is pretty clear. I do drink a lot of water, but I will show you guys in a future video. It's already recorded, just gotta edit and post what I did to keep my skin clear. Here is a very good question. Very good question. From Nikki, what do you think is key in friendship? Now let me talk about friendship. To me, friendship is being able to depend on somebody, being able to, you know, have someone to reach out to, vice versa, you know, whatever the situation is. Good or bad, doesn't matter. You should have someone there for you. That's what a friend is. A friend should be able to tell when something is wrong with the other friend and not just look past it or try to fill the void with drugs or other substances. A true friend will hang out with you regardless of the group. Cause here's a cute little fucking story.
Pause. I am literally editing this video laughing at how mad I am about to get you guys. I told y'all I would leave my shadiness, my pettiness in 2016, but you know what? Cut me some slack just this one time. I was mad.
Now I'm getting mad. Oh man, I need to calm down. I need Starbucks. Here's a cute little story. I was in the situation where I was with a couple of my friends and one of the friends decided to drift off and go hang out with other people because me and the other two people wanted to go and get sushi, right? You know, your girl loves sushi. I love me some raw fish. I wanted to go get sushi and so did they, but this one person didn't want to go. That's fine, not forcing you. But when other names were brought into it, when I said, oh, it turns out blah, 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 blah are gonna come with us, all of a sudden that friend wanted to come. Now you wanna come. Now that these big names are coming in. Interesting. So to me, friendship is not social climbing. to me, friendship is not one-sided. And that is the tea. I told y'all I wasn't gonna be petty this year. I told y'all I wasn't gonna be shady this year. I told y'all I wasn't going to, but that really grinded my gears. Juliana asked, when's your birthday and what are you gonna do for it? Girl, this year I'm about to be 21, the big 2-1. I know some of you are probably like, damn, Vanessa, I remember when you were 16, 17 years old. Yes, yes. I can't believe I'm gonna be 21 this year, y'all. Like, I am officially going to be a grown ass bitch. I'm gonna be able to drink, gamble, go to Vegas, do as I want, go dancing in the club with foreign men, do what I want. So I'm very excited for that. For my birthday, I definitely want to do something cute. I wanna go on either like a cute little trip with some of my friends. Definitely, I'm not gonna expect all my friends like, let's go to London, bitches, or let's go to France, let's go here, let's go to Belize. No, I'm not gonna do anything like that. Something very simple. Maybe I'll get a cabin by a lake and we'll all just turn up in there, or maybe we'll go to Vegas and waste all our money. I don't know yet. Literally, most of like my closest friends, like for example, Ricky is about to be 21 this upcoming week. Alexia is gonna be 21 a couple days before me. Alicia is gonna be 21 a week before me. So like, we're all turning 21, so it's just like perfect timing. A lot of people are really asking about my hair. That's so crazy. Princess underscore Hannah asked, what's the scariest thing you've ever done? Okay, honestly, the scariest thing I have ever done, and I've done this two times in my life? Three? No, I think two. I'm only recalling the time when I ran from someone from Walmart to my apartment and the time I had to run from going jogging to my parents' house. Bitch, bitch, bitch. I know some of y'all are probably like, Vanessa, we remember that time. We remember the almost getting kidnapped, me and my thumbnail with the, with the fucking duct tape, my arms, I edited the rope around. The bloody knees. Bitch, I was going jogging one day outside my parents' house. Bitch, they caught me outside. I told them catch me outside. They caught me outside. I was running to my parents' house because I was finishing up my jog, and this van tried to pull some slick shit, drive past me, open up the door, and then come back. Bitch, I ran. Then, bitch, I went to Walmart when I was living in my first apartment right after I moved out. Bitch, he was following me around the makeup section and around the groceries. He was following me around the store. And as I left, he followed me out the store. Bitch, I ran. I ended up dropping my fucking paper towels in the process. I came back to get them. They were gone. Someone stole my paper towels. Bitch, I bought like $7 paper towels. Never again. But bitch, someone stole them. How greedy. How rude. That was the scariest time of my life, bitch. Not a roller coaster. Not going bungee jumping. You know, not getting in a car accident, bitch, running. Because when you are running, it feels like the world is about to end. It feels like if I slow down now, this could be the end of me, but ooh. Go check out those story times if you haven't seen them. Kiara Diaz underscore asked me a very good question. If you can go back in time and change something, what would it be? If I can go back and change something, I would have wished I never met somebody in September. And I know a lot of you are gonna be like, Vanessa, don't be petty right now. I am not being petty. I am being honest. And I open up my life to you guys because my life as Nessa, you know, gets copyrighted by Ava. No, my life as Nessa, literally, I share everything with you guys because I feel like you guys are my family, you guys are all my friends, we're all rats together. But literally, I was caused so much trouble, so much emotional damage from one single person, and it's insane. It made me question who I was, it made me question my character, it made me really lower myself, it ruined my self-esteem. I'm like I'm not even trying to like, I'm not putting all the blame on that person because bitch, I caused it myself. I decided to be a weak ass bitch. I am that bald bitch and all my friends know this, and I can't believe I allowed myself to get that low. But bitch, this person got me there. I defended this person even when they did me wrong. I was so caught up, bitch. But literally, I was actually acting so out of character. I have never attacked another girl like that. I have never stooped down to acting like that over a fucking boy. I wish I never met that person because they've caused me nothing but trouble. And I know like you should just move on with your life and be happy, but like I really fucking hope somebody has learned through my lesson. Like I share everything with you guys, not for the purpose of I'm bashing people, I'm trying to make other people feel bad or spread hate. I'm doing it because I consider myself like a big sister or a mother to some of you, because like I will be in Instagram DMs like lecturing some of you because you'll be like, is this okay? And I'm like, honey boo boo, No. Like, I will be the big sister that you have never had. I will be the mother figure you never had. I will let you know. So that's why I talk about the situations. I make myself vulnerable. I put myself out there knowing that people are going to bash me, that they're going to hate me, they're going to say all these bad things about me, call me petty, call me shady, say what you want. But as long as I know I'm changing one life out there or preventing someone from getting in that situation, my job has been done and I feel good about myself at the end of the night. So that's why I put some of this stuff out there. And I really hope one of you, or at least some of you, learned your worth through my situation and learned that you don't need to deal with that bullshit and you don't need nobody else by yourself. You came into this world by yourself. You're gonna go out by yourself. And I'm not saying like that means be single for life, because honey, love is beautiful. Love is amazing. It's a great feeling. It's a rush. It's great. But don't confuse lust with love and don't lose yourself. Simply Noor asked a really, really good question, a couple of good questions. What really made you decide you needed to change? How are your friends affecting you negatively and your experience with toxic friends? Love you, Nessa. I love you too, boo. Before, I was such a sweet, innocent girl. Yes, I had an attitude. I'm sassy. I say what I want. I say what I think. But I was self-destructing, honestly. Like, I was saying things to people that care about me. I was being petty. I was being shady. I was like getting involved in other people's drama. I was putting myself in other situations that had nothing to do with me. I saw my life go like this, and then it started, you know, this is good, I'm consistent, and then it started going down. Y'all remember when I was posting all the time, new content, doing my thing, and then all of a sudden I just stopped. I was posting every 2 weeks. Here, there. It was getting really, really bad. And I've said this in another video, like, YouTube is my baby, it's my child. So the fact that I let something so dear to me, like, start dying and start becoming not a priority to me because of all these other things that were going on that are so stupid, that made me realize something is wrong. As for the how are your friends affecting you negatively, it wasn't, well, honestly, I'm gonna say my friends now, the friends that I have and I kept that didn't get left in 2016, I love everyone that I'm friends with right now. They've done nothing to me. But the couple of people that I left behind last year, they kept me, okay. I'm so glad I'm not wearing falsies right now, because bitch, the falsies would have to come off for this tea. The friends that I left behind, I realized didn't actually care about me. It fucking hurts your feelings at the end of the day when you actually started to care for somebody as a person and like you started to love them and not like fall in love with them, like not like that, no, but like, I said fell. But like, you started to like fall in love with that person, and then you realize that they didn't really care about you at the end of the day, and it really makes you feel like shit. It really makes you feel like, wow, I guess it wasn't real. I guess it was all the perfect illusion. The people that I cut out, and I'm gonna say this for the last time, because I commented many times about this in the comments section. A lot of people were saying you don't get addicted to weed. You can't get addicted to weed, which I have talked to many people already. Literally, I just had a conversation with my friend James, and I was telling him about that stuff, and he's like, bitch, you can get addicted. You can get addicted. Unless you've been in the situation, you can't talk about it. Because honestly, like, I don't care. Go ahead and comment again saying, no, bitch, you can't get addicted. Yes, you can. You can get addicted to anything. Strange addictions, ever heard of it? Some people get addicted to eating rocks, bitch, rocks. But you're telling me I can't get addicted to a drug? I don't care what the scientific proof or facts that you found on Google Chrome told you, bitch. I don't care what Safari told you. My life happened. I know what happened. And I've seen it happen to other people. So miss me with that bullshit. As for my experience with toxic friends, it just ties in with all of that stuff. Like, bitch, I've been recording for 20 minutes. I just went against everything I just said. I just said I wasn't gonna make this a 30-minute video. I'll try to cut it down, but honestly, I'm spitting some real shit right now that I feel a lot of people need to hear. A lot of people probably think I'm being passive aggressive. I'm being, you know, shady, but, you know, honestly, I'm at the point where I really don't care. Like, think what you want. It's okay. You have your opinion. I have mine. It's America. Say what you want. But is it really America? I paused for a second. I was like, wait, hold on. I saw this clip on Twitter today. Was it Instagram? I think it was Twitter. Trump was holding a meeting And this person stood up because they had a question. He said, okay, you can ask your question. You know how many people, reporters, press, they ask their questions. And he said, so how do you expect to build this wall and kick out over blah, 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 million people? And Trump was like, get out. I'm not answering that question. Get out. You can't ask that. And he was like, freedom of speech. I'm a citizen of this country. I can ask what I want. You said ask a question. I'm asking. Trump kicked him out. And literally, as they kicked him out, the people were like, go back to the other country, but all this stuff. Bitch, we don't have freedom of speech. I'm Canadian. Justin Bieber, hit me up. Drake, hit me up. Gigi Gorgeous, let's hang out in Canada. JX_Otwood_ asked, what are your steps you take to get you back to the happier Nessa? You said in your recent video you saw a girl you didn't recognize. How did you find you again? That is a really, really good question. I love you guys. I love that you guys are asking such good questions. Like, it's not like, what's your favorite color? Or, do you like a little Uzi Bird? I stopped a lot of the things that I started doing when I moved to LA. Now, when you move to a certain city, yes, it will change a little bit. You're in a new environment and you will adapt, just like every other species of this universe in this world. You adapt to new environments. And I feel like I adapted in the wrong way. I started falling into things I shouldn't be doing. I was saying things I shouldn't be doing. I was acting a certain way. Just everything was kind of changing me. I needed to also go back home. I went back to Arizona for about a week, week and a half. And it really humbled me again. It really made me like see my roots and where I actually came from. And seeing people that actually do care about me, which I do have friends out here in LA that do actually care about me. Don't get it twisted. I have built some really good friendships out here from, you know, the year that I have been here. But just being around people that really love me and being able to act like myself with no restrictions, being able to act like myself without feeling like I need to impress somebody, because now that I look back at it, like, I really did feel like I was like acting a certain way just to get a reaction out of some people. And that's really, really bad. You should never act like that. Just be yourself and people that are similar to you, and you guys will just bond and everything will be beautiful. But I had to get my eating back on track, because if you didn't know, I actually did develop an eating disorder, which I talked to my mom about, and it's really strange because she told me that at 19 years old she developed one too. And I don't know, like, I don't know if it's like genetic or some sort of pattern, voodoo, bruja, some witch came in, I don't know what happened. But like, I had to deal with that. I had to get that back on track, and my eating is a lot better. So I was kind of just working on everything, getting back to my old self. I cut out a lot of people that were toxic to me. I just feel a lot better. Arlene.Vera asked, where do you see yourself in 5 years? By the way, love you. Honestly, I see myself dancing in the club, strutting, getting my money, getting my coins up. Focused asked, three wishes. Let's see. So for my first wish, I would say I want to be successful, have a successful life. Two, I would hope that all my dreams would come true, as in like, the store happening, everything that I just kind of like, my big dreams, like what I really want out of this lifetime to come true. And three, I would wish for my anxiety and all of that, like all the problems to go away. But then again, at the same time, like, I don't consider them problems. I kind of consider them like things that just happen, and like, they kind of like make me who I am. Because I feel like if I didn't go through a lot of the stuff, and like, I really hope like the people who deal with this every day kind of like really listen to me when I'm saying this. Like, having anxiety and having depression or having an eating disorder or feeling worthless, like all that stuff, like, it doesn't define you as a person. It doesn't make you you. Like, you make yourself you. They're just kind of like things that just kind of like happen, you know, and it's very normal. So I hope nobody feels like they're, you know, alone in it, because honestly, you're not. But they kind of like, I feel like they made me who I am today, because if I didn't go through a lot of that stuff, I would honestly feel like everything was okay all the time, when like, really, like, they're kind of like a reality check for me. And like, I don't want them. So I'm not saying like, I want to have these I hate using the word problem. I don't want to have any disorders. I don't want to have anything like that. But I feel like they kind of like helped me mature. They helped me like really open my eyes to the world. Because somebody who's never dealt with anything like that will look at somebody who has those problems and either think they're crazy or think something's wrong with them or that they have issues. But because I've dealt with it, like, I can relate to more people. I can see both sides. I can see, I know what it's like to not deal with it, and I know what it is to deal with it. So I would, for my third wish, I would wish that it would kind of simmer down and chill out a bit and like make it controllable. But I wouldn't necessarily wish it away because I feel like it kind of helped me become who I am today, if that makes any sense. Jay Garza asked, who's your idol / inspiration? So honestly, right now, I don't know. Like, I can't really say I have an idol. I can't really say I have inspiration. I mean, one person that does inspire me would definitely have to be my mom. Here's a beautiful question. Bum yawns. How do I get over a boy I love but treats me like shit? Okay, so by saying that, you do acknowledge that he treats you like shit. And what I want to say to you, girly, is I feel like the reason you let him treat you like that is not only because you think you love him, but because you have something else going on deep down inside of you. You probably either feel like you're not going to get better than that. You probably feel like you're not worth anything, so it's okay. You probably feel like this is the best. Like, this is what normal is. But love isn't hurting people. Love isn't telling someone one thing and then going and doing the other. Love isn't... ooh, bitch, calm down. Ooh. Love isn't gonna hurt you. Like, yeah, there is pain in love. But if they're hurting you, like, if you know they're hurting you, like, obviously, like, no relationship is perfect. Things are gonna happen. But if you know they're hurting you, then, like, don't deal with it. You don't have to. There's billions of people in this world. And letting go of this one person, like, you're probably very young, I assume. And by very young, I don't mean, like, you're 13 years old. I mean, you're probably, like, you know, between, like, 12 to, like, maybe, let's say, 25 or something. Like, that's very young to me. So you're probably younger. You still have your entire life to live. You don't need to be with somebody who's hurting you because you're eventually gonna find that one. Like, every day's a new day. You wake up, brand new day, bitch. I'm a new bitch every day. So you're always, there's gonna be someone you're gonna bump into, whether maybe you're at the convenience store and that might be the love of your life, like different things. Like, someone's gonna come along that treats you right. You don't need to deal with it. None of you do. Don't put up with the bullshit, because the more they hurt you, it's just the more you're hurting yourself at the end of the day. Green Eye Goddess _, why don't we respond to all the gossip videos about you? Because I don't have to. And by that, I don't mean like in a stuck up way, like, because I don't want to, like, I don't have to. I mean it by, like, if somebody wants to make a video lying about me, if someone wants to make a video like slamming my name or something, that's something, blah, blah, blah. Been there, heard that, it's over. I really, like, I'm at the point where I'm like, okay, congratulations, cool, talk shit, good for you. Let's say a gossip channel was saying Vanessa murdered someone and she's hiding it from all of you, then I'll be like, bitch, I did not murder anyone. Like, that would be some shit to talk about. But like, if it's just like random gossip, like, I don't care. Gossip is gossip for a reason. Most of it is lies. Some people just talk to talk. So I'm not really like mad about it. Sometimes I do see in the recommended videos like this blah 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 Simply Nessa, or this Simply Nessa versus blah 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 Simply Nessa caught up in the drama of blah blah blah, and I'm just like, skip. I press the little three dots, do do do, and it says not interested, watch later, or add to blah. I press not interested because I'm not interested in hearing that. Because sometimes when you do hear things, it does make you like question yourself. So I'm not gonna put myself in the situation of hearing someone call me a liar or this, and I'm like, I know I'm not that. I've been true. Go ahead and call me what you want. I have been true to my viewers. I have been true to my family. I have been true to everything, so I really don't care. I feel like the people that go on you now, that go on live, that go on broadcast, the ones that are really trying to defend themselves, really trying to like say everything they can, are the ones that are getting caught up in it. They're the ones that most likely are lying, most likely are trying to cover their tracks. Like, that's how I feel I would end up looking. Like, if I'm going on every gossip channel, it's like, no, don't say bad things about me. Don't say that. Like, you're just trying to cover your tracks or like make yourself look good. But really, if you put out good content, if you have a good heart and you're just a good person in general, you don't have to worry about what people are saying about you. Hasselia Coyne or Coyne, sorry, I can't say your name. But she asked, or he, how many special females in your life at the moment as in girlfriend material? Just wondering, LOLs. So, as of right now, none. I'm not really trying to talk to any boys. I'm not trying to talk to any girls. I'm trying to focus on myself because before I try to focus on someone else, I need to fix me and really do me right now. Like, here's a really good one. A lot of you guys are asking about, do you have any beef with anyone right now? Here's the last one, and this is gonna be the last time I talk about it. I have no beef with anybody, you guys. I don't have a problem with anyone. I left my problems in 2016. 2K16. So that is that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I did spill a little bit of tea. I did get pretty real with you guys. I hope nobody thinks this is shade. I do hope that nobody you know, takes it the wrong way, because honestly, I'm just trying to like do me. I'm just trying to say what I have to say, and if you don't like what I have to say, you can leave my channel. There's a cute little button below. It's called subscribe. If you are not subscribed to my channel below, make sure you go ahead and click it. You know, just a cute little red color. I love the color red, you know. It's a just a cute button. If you want to click it, it's down there. Go ahead. And if you don't follow me already on Twitter and Instagram or Snapchat, everything is going to be on the screen as well, I think. Actually, I don't think my Snapchat's gonna show up. I think it's just my Instagram and Twitter. But that's on the description below if you guys want to check it out. But yeah, that's it. Make sure you check out some more of my videos if you're new to my channel or if you haven't been keeping up with me, you know, keeping up with the Nessas. And I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye!